Hello, and welcome back to my channel. It's been really, really cold over the Christmas holiday here in Pennsylvania, in the Harrisburg area where I live. So I'm going to do a combination will it start, cold start video. Hopefully it's a success. Truck's been sitting for 4 days, and super nasty cold. When I parked it on the Thursday before Christmas, it was raining and everything was wet, so I might have a bunch of stuff frozen up. I might even have to heat up my door locks just to get the thing unlocked. So let's have some fun with this and find out. So here we are. The door was not frozen shut, which I was very pleased with. Opened right up. I'm gonna jump in here and see if this thing's going to start. A couple taps on the fuel there. See what happens. Jump in here, keep giving it fuel. About 24 degrees. Like I said, it's been sitting for 4 days. Some people might not think that's all that spectacular, but I'm pretty happy with it. Seeing as how this truck is actually older than me, it's 50 years old, 49. Letting it warm up so I can be in here early tomorrow morning and jump in it, get back to work this week. Probably another long weekend this coming weekend with the New Year's holiday. So, yeah, pretty happy, very, very happy. I had brought tools and a bunch of other stuff.
ether, jumper cables, that type of stuff to make sure the thing would start. My neighbor here, where I park, he's got his truck running right now. But he's nowhere around, so I've got to give this a couple of minutes, let it build up air pressure, make sure none of my brakes are frozen up.
Family and
about Christ and what Christ ultimately did for us, and that was give himself on the cross for our sins on Good Friday and Resurrection Sunday. So I'll stop with my preaching now, and I'll get back to my truck garbage. I just hope that everybody had a blessed Christmas. I hope that any of you that felt alone or sadness, I feel alone and sadness on Christmas. I have family members that I haven't seen in years and don't particularly want anything to do with me for whatever reason. I have my scenarios that run through my head, but I hope that everybody who feels alone or scared or anything during the holidays and feels abandoned, there's no reason to feel that way. That there are people out there that love and care about you. And I would really love it if you're a person who feels alone or trapped. Search out those people. There's some really great Christian groups out there. I'm not going to say churches so much, because a lot of churches are a mess. I don't want to call out any one church, but there's some bad ones out there. But then there's some really amazing churches out there. The people of those churches will bend over backwards to make you feel loved, make you feel welcome. And they won't look at the crap that you've gone through in your life. They will care about you for the person that you are. So I just ask that anybody that feels like that, just go and search out a Christian group like that. They're out there, trust me. You don't have to look hard. I'm not going to go into the denominations to avoid, most of the time, avoid a denomination. That's pretty much my rule. So, like I said, I hope everybody had a blessed Christmas. I'm going to get back to my truck recording my videos here. Got the sidetrack. You know, oh, look, a squirrel. Hey, look at that. Yeah, woo! Next to an elephant. Yeah. So, while I'm letting this thing run and just kind of sit there and run and waste my $6 a gallon fuel in a truck that uses about a gallon every half hour when idling, yeah. Gonna check out the back of this trailer here and see what kind of a mess I'm looking at in here. I wanted to bring my broom, but I totally forgot. Got sidetracked with some other stuff. Oh boy. Yeah, let me switch you around here so you can see what kind of a mess I get to clean up tomorrow morning. Yeah. All this has got to go. It's not horrible. It's a heck of a lot better than your average XPO trailer. But it's all got to come on out. So, that's what she said. means I gotta...
This doesn't shut off automatically when you turn the key off. I have to pull this lever out, which attached to a cable, which shuts the fuel off down underneath the hood. And then when you start it, you got to turn the key to the run position and then hit the start button. Kind of a lot different than your Craftpedia, but you know, that's how they did things back in 1973. So, I think I'm gonna get this thing locked up. I'm gonna go back to my warm house. Make sure she's locked. There we go.
So, I hope y'all enjoyed my little cold start / will it start video. Like and share, subscribe, blah, blah, blah. Share it on your Facebook page or FaceSpace or InstaFace or whatever the heck you have. I don't know. I'm old. I'm not on social media. Maybe I should go and open up some sort of page or something like that. Just share pictures of this big, ugly red thing out here, you know. So, like I said, like, subscribe, share for more. I'm going to try my best to keep videos coming and keep them interesting. Try not to run out of ideas or anything like that. So, hope everybody has a blessed day, and thank you for watching.